So this is my Bookish Week, a day late and a dollar short, and today is No Makeup Sunday, so you're welcome. Hey BookTube, it's Kim at Middle of the Book March, and this is my Bookish Week, a little late. March, let's see. Saturday, today's the 14th. Preparation would go a very long way. So, what did I do last week in a bookish way? It's a really super exciting reason why I'm here on Sunday instead of Saturday. But let me recap what I read last week. I finished one book, and it's Bluebird, Bluebird by Attica Locke. Holy cow, is this good! This is the story of Darren Matthews, who is a Black Texas Ranger. In the very beginning of the book, he is caught up in a kind of a family, longtime friend drama who... his friend is on trial or in front of a grand jury for possible murder. There's a question about a member of the Aryan Brotherhood in Texas who was shot to death. And the authorities believe that the Darren Matthews, the Texas Ranger, a longtime friend of his family, is guilty. So there's a trial going on and Darren Matthews' career is on the line. That's not the main storyline, but it is an important one. The main storyline is that there is the investigation of the murder of a young white woman in a predominantly Black rural town in East Texas. I think it's East Texas. And at the same time, there is the death of a young Black lawyer from Chicago. And at first, most, if not all, of the investigation is on the white girl's death and not the Black man's death. And so Darren Matthews ends up going down there to kind of figure out if there's a connection and what caused both of those deaths. So there's police procedural, I guess you could call it, mystery, narrative regarding race, especially race in Texas and the South. It was so good. And this is a perfect example of my epic failure of a read-along, because this was a read-along with a bunch of the members of our These Truths reading group. And poor Sharon, Sharon Goforth, was the leader of this read-along, because many of us said, yeah, I want to read that. I read the assigned amount for the first week, and then by the middle of the second week, I was basically done with the book. I'm an epic failure because I tend to do this with almost every read-along and slash buddy read. It's like I just want to speed up and read it because it was so good. So, yep, I'm sorry, epic fail. And now everybody is on, I think most of us have finished it, and we have one or two members of our read-along who have been speeding up to catch up, and I'm sorry, it's probably my fault. Super good. I am looking forward to receiving Heaven My Home, the second installment in this series, in the mail anytime, and we'll maybe read that in April or May. I don't know if I'll be able to fit it in. That's all I finished last week, and I'm going to quickly show you what I'm currently reading. I just started Now in November by Josephine Johnson, a 1936 Pulitzer Prize winner. This is fiction set in the South after the Depression, of a family with three young girls who moves from the city to a very highly mortgaged farm where they're just trying to survive. And if you are a fan of nature writing or writing that is rich with landscape description, this is the book for you. It's gorgeous. And I saw this on Kelly's channel at Books I'm Not Reading. She read every single Pulitzer Prize winner ever, and this was one of them that she has gushed about. So it's beautifully written. I am still reading Roots, Alex Haley's Roots for March of the Mammoths. And I am reading the George Eliot biography by Frederick R. Carl, George Eliot, Voice of a Century. This is interesting. I have some definite thoughts on this and the author of this biography. So I love reading about George Eliot. She was a fascinating piece of British literature, fascinating author, and a fascinating person. So I'm really interested in her story, but I have some definite thoughts about that. So that's what I'm currently reading. I'm currently caught up for These Truths. I will be reading that again next quarter for the last section of the book. So why am I here on Sunday? Because all day yesterday we were book buying. We went to two libraries. These two libraries One of them has a regular book sale room that they usually open once a month. But this one, I don't know, I think I said in one of my previous videos that they had a sale a couple weeks ago, but it snowed that day, so we couldn't make it. And my husband called, and he got a private booking. So we ended up being able to go yesterday. And I got a little pile of books there. And then there was another library on our way home from that one that has an ongoing book giveaway room where you can take any books you want and just give a donation. And my daughter and I were the only ones in the room. They didn't have a lot of stuff, but I walked out of there with 5 books. And my daughter got one, and I think we donated $3. But first, we did go to a regular bookstore, and I bought 2 books off the bargain table. And the first one is The Autobiography of Martin Luther King Jr. edited by Claiborne Carson. This one says, it claims that the estate of Martin Luther King Jr. Approved this biography, or it says it's an autobiography. So it's basically a compilation of his letters and diaries, and his estate approved the publication of this book. So I'm really looking forward to reading this, learning more about him, learning even more than I already know based on history and previous writings and documentaries and that type of thing. So I was really glad to find that. And then this one is Kate Atkinson's Big Sky in hardcover. This is this is a continuation of the Jackson Brody series. And this is again, I'm guilty of this as well. I have several authors where I'm collecting their books, and I may have only read one or two of their previous novels, but I've got like a whole bunch of their books in a series, and she's one of those authors for me. This, again, a continuation of the Jackson Brody. I think he's a detective or a police officer. I don't want to really tell you the topic or the plot because, again, it's a continuation in a series. But I was really happy to find this in hardcover. So those are the 2 bargain books that I bought. The rest of these are library sale books. I spent $11 on library books, and my daughter got a stack, not just a couple. She got probably altogether 8, 9, 10 books. I got 10, 11. I think there might be 10 here. 11. Some of them are thin. So I'll show you in the past tense. Let me show you what I picked up. Now, if you are a library sale connoisseur like I am, I only pick up books that are in pristine condition. And one of these, again, I think I said one of these sales is a room where you pick up anything you want and take it home for donation. The other one, the books are 50 cents. There are a couple of exceptions that were special sales, and I'll tell you those when I get to them. This one is The Lexus and the Olive Tree, Thomas L. Friedman's Understanding Globalization. This book was published 20 years ago, I think, 1999. So I read a little bit of this for a business class years ago and never finished it, and have been interested in finishing it ever since. It's a really interesting commentary on globalization around the world. In the very end of this the blurb says, finding the proper balance between the Lexus and the Olive Tree is the great drama of the globalization era and the ultimate theme of Friedman's challenging, provocative book, essential reading for all who care about the world, how the world really works. It's clearly nonfiction, and I'm really interested in finally finishing that book. I think the rest of these, no, that one's nonfiction. Oh, I've got a couple of memoirs / biographies. Let me get those together. And I think the rest of these, oh, that's another memoir. Oh, so I'll show you these memoirs first. This one is John Irving, My Movie Business, a memoir. I'm a big John Irving fan, and I've read several, not all of his books. But I'm interested, this has always been on my radar, but I didn't tend to pick up any of his nonfiction because I was just consumed with his fiction. And several of his books have been made into movies, so I thought this would be fun to read. This one is Edwidge Danticat's Brother, I'm Dying. She is the author of Breath, Eyes, Memory. And this was published in 2007. This is a work of nonfiction, a powerfully moving family story that centers around the men closest to her heart, her father, Mira, and his older brother, Joseph. From the age of four, Edwidge Danticamp became to think of her uncle Joseph, a charismatic pastor, as her second father when she was placed in his care after her parents left Haiti for a better life in America. Listening to his sermons, sharing coconut-flavored ices on their walks through town, roaming through the house that held together many members of a colorful extended family, Edwidge grew profoundly attached to Joseph. He was the man who knew all the verses for love. She joins her parents in New York City at the age of 12, and she is reunited with her two youngest brothers and her mother and father, whom she has struggled to remember. But she must also leave behind Joseph and the only home she's ever known. I really love that cover, and this is her on the back of the book. And again, it's a former library book, and so it's got the Mylar cover, which I absolutely love. I don't know why, but I do. So this one is a book by Mary Gordon, Circling My Mother, a memoir. Now, again, former library book. Look at the edges are so clean, and it doesn't look like anybody ever checked it out. Mary Gordon, a memoir, Circling My Mother. And again, a really pretty cover on this one. This is a fiction, it's a memoir. Anna Gagliano Gordon, who died in 2002 at the age of 94, lived a life colored by large forces, immigration, World War, the Great Depression, and physical affliction. She contracted polio at the age of 3 and experienced the ravages of both alcoholism and dementia. She was a hardworking single mother. Gordon's father died when she was still a girl. She was the personification of the culture of the mid-century American Catholic working class. Yet even in the face of setbacks, she managed to hold down a job, to dress smartly, and to raise her daughter on her own. That sounds really good. And this is the type of book that it had never, ever been on my radar. I didn't know existed, but when I found it and started to read the blurb and the summary, it sounded really good. This one, again, it looks like it was never checked out, a library discard. This is Byron in Love, A Short Daring Life by Edna O'Brien. Here we go with another author, Edna O'Brien, a bunch of whose books I've collected and still have without having read them all yet. This is Byron as a mythic figure, a superb poet and insatiable lover, the epitome of the great artist who dies young. His very name suggests wildness, rebelliousness, artistic frenzy. Born in 1788, Byron has transcended his age more than any other poet, inspiring generations of poets, artists, even rock stars. Often inscrutable to the most dedicated biographers, Byron's life has begged for a poetic interpretation that appreciates the untrammeled qualities of his artistic soul. And again, the cover got me. I got the cover. Picked it up. Saw Edna O'Brien as the author and read the blurb and bought it. Actually, I didn't buy that one. That was a donation book. So if I had bought it, it would have probably cost me 50 cents. Now the rest of these, I think these are all fiction. I'm not going to go too far into these. I don't think I need to. There's two of them that I might. This one is An Chi Minh's Becoming Madam Mao. And I'm superficial, people. My favorite color is red. I saw the cover. I had heard of this title before. I picked it up. It's got the library plastic covering on it for a paperback. It'll last forever, just like Twinkies, so I bought it. From the best-selling author of Red Azalea, this extraordinary novel tells the stirring, erotically charged story of Madame Mao Zedong, the woman almost universally known as the White Bone Demon, who many hold directly responsible for the excesses of the Cultural Revolution. It's a novel, it's fiction, but looks super good. And let's see, these two are the same author, and I've never heard of him. They are tiny little novels that were library discards. People, these are like never been read. And I was attracted to them because they were so short, and I read the blurbs, and I thought, these sound really good. And it sounds like an author that I would probably like, that the writing would be really nice. This is from Castle Freeman Jr., All That I Have, a very short novel, and Go With Me, again, a very short novel. This one is The Vermont Hill Country is the stark, vivid setting for this gripping and entertaining story of bold determination. The local villain, Blackway, is making life hellish for Lillian, a young woman from parts elsewhere. Her boyfriend has fled the state in fear, and local law enforcement can do nothing to protect her. She resolves, however, to stand her ground and to fight back. The author is from Newfane, Vermont, or he lives in Newfane, Vermont. This was published by Steerforth Press in Hanover, New Hampshire, where Dartmouth is. I live in New Hampshire. And copyright 2008. So I'm expecting some really beautiful writing, maybe set in Vermont, and that looked really good. This one, again, this cover photo. I'm not a fan of photos on books, but this one was like, I have to know what that photo is saying. Freeman's pleasantly wicked fourth novel set in small town rural Vermont. Yes, again, one of the reasons why I was attracted to these books is Vermont. I love Vermont. Explores the moral choices of a good-hearted, meek sheriff. The laconic and gently self-deprecating sheriff Lucian Wing, a middle-aged ex-navyman married to a prominent lawyer's daughter, has to decide whether to arrest a young ne'er-do-well who has broken into an opulent home owned by mysterious Russians and stolen a safe. These novels are less than 200 pages, so maybe novellas, but both of them looked really fascinating. The next three, these are the last three. I don't think I'm going to have to give you much description. This is Mr. Rochester by Sarah Shoemaker, and this was a donated book. This is one of those books I have had on my radar, but I wasn't interested enough to shell out the money, but I mean, 50 cents for a hardcover. I picked that one up. I think this might be a biography. This is The Black Count by Tom Reese. Glory, Revolution, Betrayal, and the Real Count of Monte Cristo. You put the Count of Monte Cristo anywhere in a description on the cover of a book, I'm going to buy it. So I think this is a biography. You guys, tell me if I'm wrong. Yeah, I think so. It's narrative nonfiction, but they had it in the fiction section. So I am so in for learning about The Real Count of Monte Cristo, one of my favorite books of all time. It's up there with Middlemarch. This is the last book I have. This is, again, looks pristine, which makes me sad because I've heard wonderful things about this book. It's a Man Booker Prize winning book, The Line of Beauty by Alan Hollingshurst. And the hardcover with the plastic cover on it. The very bottom of the blurb says, framed by the two general elections that return Margaret Thatcher to power, The Line of Beauty unfurls through four extraordinary years of change and tragedy. Richly textured, emotionally charged, disarmingly funny, this is a major work by one of our finest writers. There's a bunch of stuff going on in this book, and I think many of you have already heard about this, so I didn't want to go into too much detail. I lied. I have two other books. I don't have to give you any description, though. These were special purchases because many years ago in a galaxy far, far away, I was an old book collector. Nothing that was super expensive. I just bought old novels, typically classics, because those are the ones that are old, and I loved them. And for whatever reason, I got rid of them during moves or gave them away or whatever it was. And I have since become very sad about that I did that. But I found two special purchases at the library, and each of these was a dollar. There's a third book that I did buy, but this is a teaser because that's going to be in a video hopefully next week. Stay tuned. This one is Don Quixote by Miguel de Cervantes. Look at this. This is an old hardcover. The pages are just pristine. New edition translated by Edith Grossman. And if you show me a classic translated by a female translator, I'm going to be all over it. This particular book was copyrighted in 2003, introduced by Harold Bloom. So I'm really liking the fact that I can have this on my shelf. The print, the text is really big, which is good for me. I look at that. There's not any illustrations in here, but I really like how this book is put together. That's one of the section introductions. And then the last one, another special purchase, one of my favorite books of all times and one of the best books ever written, John Steinbeck's The Grapes of Wrath. And look at this one, in wonderful shape. That's the hardback illustration, really great pages. This particular book was published in 1930. Well, the copyright is 1939. This book was created in 1958. This was one of the books I read in school and was gloriously happy to have read. And I have like the Penguin Deluxe edition of this paperback. And when I saw this, I'm like, yeah, that book is mine. It's mine. And I'm so tempted to show you another one that I got, but I'm not going to do that. So these were my two special buys that I can add to my old book collection. They don't even smell bad. They were perfect. So that's what I did last week, people. I've got a whole pile going for my TBR for April. I don't have any books that are not on a buddy read or a read-along. I've got my pile, and I won't be able to deviate because there's so many, but I love it. I love the books that I keep looking over at them. I love the books in my pile. I can't wait. I can't wait to get to April. Not that I want to speed up time, but it's going to be fun. Tell me down below what you think of any of these books. I had a pretty good haul yesterday, and tell me if you've read any of them, what you think, what you've read that you've loved lately, and if you've hauled anything, tell me anything you want. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye, everybody.